Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough starting Vision 6-2 right now, a day later, unless, you know, you're watching these in order from the playlist or something like that. But anyway, I digress. 6-2 is a very hard stage. Well, okay, it's not that hard, but it's one of the hardest in the game. There's a lot of tricky one-block jumps, and... What did you just say?
We've been waiting for you. I have terrible news. The kingdom has been taken over by a fiend named Ghadius.
What did you say?
That's kind of to be expected, though. I mean, he is the villain. Doesn't she look like a lot like Lafis? What?
Mother?
If the egg should hatch, the consequences would be too terrible to imagine.
I understand. Mother, you and the others should stay back.
Yes, yeah, send the kid into battle, not the more capable adults. Actually, Hupo is pretty careful. I mean, he is very capable. Why did I say careful? What?
It's just, I'm actually the Prince of KraD, the Moon Kingdom.
What?
Dun dun dun!
I was just disguised as a ring spirit. There was a reason that I had to go to the outside world.
Why?
I'm really sorry, but I can't tell you what that reason was yet. But I promise I'll explain everything later. Right now, I need you to trust me. Will you please help me for just a little bit longer? Just a little bit longer. Please, Klonoa?
Hupo. Of course I will. After all, we're best friends, aren't we?
Woo!
Thank you, Klonoa. You don't know how much this
Well, Hupo, it appears you found yourself a good friend.
Oh, absolutely, Mother! Now you should go and take shelter someplace safe with the others.
Hupo, we're counting on you. Do your best.
I will!
We can do this! Alright, starting the level. Something very interesting is that there's an invisible wall here. Yeah, I don't get it either. Anyway, things are getting serious. Listen to that music. Okay, it's not that serious of music, but it definitely had a more foreboding beat to it at the start there. Alright, so you got this crystal thingy in the center there. What that is, we will find out later. But we're going to see that place a couple of times. Now, see that door over there? You can't get to that door, but that is your destination. And you'll notice that there is this pillar in the way with one of those switch-like symbols there. We are going to take care of that by going through this door and facing the challenges ahead. Remember I said to get used to the one-block jumps? Yep, down is death. I've said it before and I'll say it again. No, 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 no. Yep. Wow, I got really lucky there. And yeah, that's what you gotta be careful of, is so that enemies don't knock you into the abyss. Alright, what do we have here? It seems to be a small jumping puzzle room of sorts. This I can do. This I shouldn't have much trouble with, except that I did. I have to stay up there, you know, to be able to jump up to the next platform. That is a key component, PkGam. You can't forget about that. And I'm gonna jump rope the critters. There we go. And bouncy guys down there and a checkpoint. I believe that they only jump towards you once you get down here. It's kind of tricky to get underneath them at times, but it'll be okay, I'm sure. Get. Oh, I absolutely cannot miss the trapped villagers because, you know, 100%ing thing. It's possible to get down there without taking a hit, but it's very, very tight. So don't count on being able to do it all the time. Whoa! Sir Kibble. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I did a terrible job dodging that boomerang. That crystal, don't worry about that for now. Oh, you're gonna jump twice. Wait, did it? Oh, okay. So you jump twice, then you move forward. Got it. Boop. Just gonna get rid of him right away, because he's gonna get drastically in the way. You wanna hit that switch? I don't think you can do it normally without an enemy. Yeah, that's what I thought. Just jam it right down the center. Woo! Yeah, like I said, don't even worry about the crystal. I always wonder though if these crystals like pop if you get a later one, because there's more of those kinds of pink crystals in level. I don't believe they do. Then again, I've never looked. I don't know the purpose of those pink crystals popping anyway, because you see it would just lead you down to this path anyway. So I don't think those in particular do. Okay, now we got another puzzle room of sorts. What we got to do is hit all three of those switches within a certain amount of time. You'll notice that they don't stay lit for very long, so... Oh, shoot. That is not going to work. Gotta try it again. You have to hit them at a very, very tight timing, and it's a matter of figuring out the best way to hit them all, just like that. And there's a couple of puzzles like that throughout this level. And now the pillar moves out of your way happily. Now watch this when you go through the door. Sand slide! Woo! And it's over. Okay, that's not really all that special. I just wanted to make a big deal out of that for nothing. By the way, you can't jump off this platform until it reaches the top, so don't worry about falling or anything like that. Just saying. And you gotta do the roundabout here. This gets closer with each door that you go through and each passageway that you open up. That's what those little open holes in the floor were that you jumped over on the way there. It's really, really good level design in that way, that it just keeps leading you back to the same essential hub of sorts. I really like that when that level like ties... Phew, I got lucky there! When it seems to like tie itself together very well like that. I guess I could use these you guys. Get it? Yes! Oh, I was scared to fall there. Now I gotta do rigmarole again, because otherwise I just can't like jump right through them, you know, without taking a hit. Wait, I need to stun you, jump on you, get up here, grab the birdie, and for schnaggle my way up there. Good. Hopefully I haven't missed anything. I really hope I'm not missing anything, because I feel like I'm blowing through these levels pretty quickly here. Ooh. But do I want to pop them both? I'm not sure, actually. Let's see what that does. Just give me crystals and a heart. I guess that was completely unnecessary. Whoa! I would like to pop the thing by going below. I can jump down there, right? Okay. I wasn't sure about that, because in my practice, I just did it by, you know, using an enemy and just flopping it down there. Okay, I'm just gonna have to double jump there. Okay. No problem. Whoa. That could have been a catastrophe. I would have been cornered. I wouldn't have stood a chance. Okay, I would have. I have loads of health. This is one of those places that you gotta offset the timing of these hexagonal platforms, you know, the way they disappear, like that. Another spot right here. Grab an enemy! Oh, shoot! Wait, this worked out? I thought I would have had to, you know, do the hover jump to get up there, but the timing was set in just the right way. Boop. And moving on! With a slight bit of backtracking. Yeah, the music in this level is really nice. It's like bagpipes every once in a while. As I said, the foreboding feel of the level. Hello. Yeah, I probably want you... I bet you I need to take an enemy up there. Probably this guy. Yeah, because I believe those switches are in the foreground, not the background. I'm just gonna test that out. Yeah, I can't hit them. That's what I thought. Because you notice that they're bigger in size, so that's how I was able to tell by perspective where they were on the screen. Alright, so I have to stun you. Because I need two enemies up there to pop the front switches. I'm gonna do it like that. Grab the birdie. Hopefully get over to the third switch. Yes! That one seemed pretty generous in the timing, actually. Because I had a lot of little fumblings in there that burned a lot of time, and it still worked out. Ooh, we're here! Yeah, I don't know why I'm making such a big deal of those things, but I am. It's just for fun, really. It's not any real meaning behind it, just like the backward titles on the videos. I try to make quirky titles on the videos nowadays just for entertainment's sake. Alright! There should be another checkpoint coming up if I'm not mistaken. There's one after each of these pillars. Alright, and you see the door was right there. I'm not even gonna bother to go trying to go back and get that fairy. Oh shoot. I'm screwed, aren't I? Yeah, I thought so. Alright, I need to do that better. I'm gonna have to use the birdie to my advantage. Good! Definitely gotta get up here quickly. Wait, you aren't gonna- Whoa! Please don't jump up here. Please don't jump up here, okay. But how do I get up? Oh, you. Whoa! I was a little worried that I messed up my chain there, but it worked out. I gotta pop the little plant buddies here. Which means that I need you. And I need you to cooperate with me as well. By, you know, dying. And wait it out. Good. Our path is clear. Checkpoint! Bouncy guy, come down here. Come on. There you go, good boy. Wait, I actually need you. Aha! Wait. It's not like that's blocked by the crystal thingy. I need to get above you. Delightful! Now I can hit the switch. Or, I need an enemy to hit the switch. Wait. I can get that first. Completed level! Switch hits. What's the point of going up on top of that platform? There's probably something up there. I'm just gonna take a look-see for the heck of it. Come on, Sir Kibble. Whoop! I think it's just a heart. Is that just a heart? Yeah, it's just a heart. Not really worth it, but it's there if you want it, I suppose. And I'm going to take your body to use as a weapon. I'm sorry, that's just how things gotta be, and I'm gonna use it here. Oh, I remember this place. You gotta do this place in one run, and it's pretty tricky to do so. Like, if you were to fall down a level after missing a jump, these boomerang guys won't respawn until you touch the very bottom floor. Yeah. It's done in such a way that you gotta be more precise in this spot than any other spot in the game. Well, I guess it's not any other spot in the game, but what I mean is that is like you gotta be more consistent. These jumps aren't all that hard as a whole. It's just a matter of you gotta know how to do the jumps, and I did it! Yay! Oh, it's a pretty long jump, long drop there.
Oh, this room.
This one gave me a lot of trouble my first run through the game. What you want to do is get up here, wait for the enemies to respawn, and also watch the timing of those Gordo enemy things. And gotta wait for a clearing. I should say wait for them timed for a clearing. And hit the background one. Hit the background. Yes. Well, it wasn't done smoothly, but it was done. That one also seemed to give you a lot of extra time to finish it. guess we get to do again? No! Okay. As I said, you get closer and closer to the platform that you have to backtrack to each time by these little gaps in the floors. Yep. See, like, we're right here this time. The other one was one space back, the other one was two spaces back. And now we can get over to the golden door. This place is beautiful. Just look at that. You can't tell me that isn't beautiful. So shiny. Mirror-like gorgeousness. And as you can tell, heart, extra life, heart, we are coming up to something pretty big. What? Klonoa can fly? Well, we didn't need Pamela then. This is blasphemy. Come to think of it, why doesn't Klonoa just fly through this? Never mind. Shouldn't question the game logic. So what?
I must say I'm surprised. I never would have thought that you'd make it all the way here.
Really? It was kind of programmed in the game. Oh, never mind.
Well, I'm afraid you're just a little too late.
Again? Well, now you know his motive.
There's no way that we're gonna let you do this.
As you wish, I will show you the error of your ways.
Bring it on! Alright, in this boss battle, you want to avoid these yellow spheres, otherwise this will happen, and you have to get to the other yellow sphere. In this part, you cannot hurt him at all. That's why you want to avoid them. I just wanted to show that for the heck of it. Alright, first phase, you got the eggs and you got the enemies. Avoid the egg things and just grab the enemies and throw them into his cloak. Well, you can also pop the egg things as well. But otherwise, you just want to focus on the enemies most of all. Now shoot! Did not mean to jump into the yellow orb. Go! 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 Yes! That's why you want to avoid them, because it's a break in the action as well. Alright, you can't grab them when they're spinning around that circle, so don't even bother. You just gotta wait for them to drop down on top of your head. Oh, dang it. Yeah, you can't grab those, as I just demonstrated there. Oh, didn't mean to throw it like that. Throw them into the background when I tell you to throw them into the background, Klonoa. Alright, this is a phase 2 of the battle. I believe he switches phases as you go. I don't know if it has to do with health or it has to do with time. But in this one, these chain-like worm things or whatever the heck they are, you just gotta grab the enemies on the back of them and throw them back at him. Sort of like the first phase. I think this is a lot easier than the first phase, actually. It's a lot more predictable. And it's a lot less tight. Needless to say, the ring that you're on is also... It's also rotating, so that may throw you off your balance as well, so be careful of that. Just be wary of where you are and where you will be as long as you're, you know, standing. If you're not doing anything, it may lead you into an enemy. And is it going to go into the third phase of Triangle? I believe so. What you want to do here is grab the whatever thing. It looks like some kind of jellyfish. And pull it off, which will deplete that electric field thing, and those enemies will be freed. Yeah, like that. And pay attention to where his arm is pointing as well. Why is it so hard to grab these guys? Because where his arm points is where the triangle is going to go. Yeah. Oh. Right there. Okay. Oh, dang it. And you obviously cannot, you know, or ignore it, because you have to, you know, get the enemies out of there. Dang it. Do not touch the yellow thing. Kill him. Yeah! We are the master! He explodes, yet he didn't disappear. Hmm. Again, no questioning game logic, dang it. I'm just, you know, a logical or meaningful explanation. An observation. The gang's all here.
You all came!
Blast it! I wanted to be the one to get rid of that guy.
Wonderful. I just knew you two would be able to do it.
With this peace return.
Very good. Very good indeed.
You did!
Klonoa, you. I'm glad you're both unharmed.
Mother, we did it! We defeated him! I guess this means it's finally over, isn't it?
I wouldn't be so sure. I already have more than enough nightmare energy. The body of the songstress Lefis will be taken over, and Nahatum will at last be brought to life. All the world's dreams pass through a prism and become the building blocks that give form to the world of Phantomile. So long as the power of dreaming exists, no one will ever be able to stop Nahatu.
We're not gonna let you get away with this, Ghadius. We still have the power to stop you.
Strange dream. Well, that dream can and will be eliminated by Nahatu. Hear me, strange dream. This world is coming to an end. And the perfect nightmare is about to begin!
Was talking about you, Klonoa.
What? What do you mean?
I don't have time to explain it all to you right now. We have to get to the top. KraD, please take us up.
Just leave it to me.
What does that all mean? Find out in the next part. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you there.